Hennepin County voters made a choice last November for a new leader in the county attorney's office. In a landslide victory, you picked Mary Moriarty. She ran her campaign as a reformer focused on equity and rehabilitation, not punishment in criminal justice. But recently, as she's made choices about brokering more lenient plea deals, there has been a loud clap back. Yesterday, for the second time, that clap was a gavel when a judge in Hennepin County said no to a deal for an accused criminal. So tonight we want to get into where this leaves the role of Moriarty as the Hennepin County attorney. Lou, she says she's doing what she was chosen to do by voters, but not able to get it done in some cases because others are saying she's going too far.
Yeah, Jana, Moriarty's office has pointed out that these high-profile cases where the victim families have protested make up a tiny percentage of the thousands of cases and plea deals handled each year. But those victim families say Moriarty's philosophies leave them feeling like no one is fighting for them.
We have been lied to repeatedly by the Hennepin County Attorney's Office.
The family of Steve Markey did not hold back while giving victim impact statements.
Mary Moriarty's behavior in this case and other cases like this is a disgrace to the justice system.
Criticizing Hennepin County Attorney Mary Moriarty while asking Judge Michael Burns to reject the plea deal that would keep a young man involved in their loved one's murder out of prison.
She's giving him a slap on the hand and counseling. We're shocked. We can't believe this.
I'm asking you, Your Honor, please don't let murderers walk our streets.
Judge Burns disagreed with Moriarty's office about the amount of progress Hussein Braveheart has made with treatment and programming.
Progress that was punctuated by outbursts, disrespect to staff and other residents, episodes of physical violence, harassment to staff and other residents.
And Burns ultimately did what the Markey family wanted.
I am not accepting Mr. Braveheart's guilty plea at this time.
It was another high-profile blow to Moriarty's goal of reforming how juvenile suspects are treated in the criminal justice system. In April, Minnesota Attorney General Keith Ellison asked Governor Tim Walz to take away from Moriarty the case involving the murder of Zaria McKeever, which also includes juvenile suspects.
Well, I think it's extraordinary.
Alan Harris was a Hennepin County prosecutor for 36 years, leading the adult prosecution division when he retired in 2020.
First of all, I don't know that the electorate fully understands what she's talking about when she talks about reforming the juvenile system. There's room for improvement at every level of the criminal justice system, but I don't know that the average person would have expected that murder cases and serious robbery cases and serial robbery cases would be getting treated so leniently.
This is what she ran on, but now other people in the system are not allowing her to fulfill the platforms of her campaign.
Assistant Professor Julie Jonas from the University of St. Thomas Law School points out a key piece of Moriarty's platform was considering brain development when assessing crimes committed by juveniles and was elected to be a progressive prosecutor.
And that was very, very clearly her platform.
But Jonas notes the decisions made by Judge Burns and Attorney General Ellison reflect concerns about the rights of victims.
Mary Moriarty sent a long statement to go along with this story. You can read it in its entirety at care11.com. It says, in part, the standard I have set as county attorney is that we'll do the right thing based on the unique circumstances of each case to protect public safety by holding individuals accountable in meaningful and effective ways. For far too long, the criminal justice system has reflexively equated justice with the longest possible prison sentence while ignoring data that shows long prison sentences do not necessarily improve public safety. Jana.
Lou, you have had a professional relationship with Mary Moriarty for a long time, meaning you've talked to her a lot for the stories that you cover. Does she seem surprised by what's happening in just these two cases with judges or with families reacting the way they are?
To be honest, I don't have an answer to that question. I think that she was definitely surprised when Keith Ellison, the attorney general, took that case away from her. She held a press conference the next day and was very upset about that. I think yesterday it took everyone by surprise when Judge Burns made that decision because it seemed like it was headed towards him accepting that plea.
Okay, Lou, thank you so much.